Michigan to perform tree trimming for the amount not to exceed $8,000. Funds will be provided from the Department of Public Works Right-of-Way Act 48. Mr. Bach.
Just take us through to the beginning of the budget year. This is for the area of Catherine and Wayfair and Birch and Hip and Avalon. Get the trees trimmed. Come July 1st, we'll have our budget replenished just to get us to that point.
Will this bid out?
Yes, tree trim was bid out. It's a new bid. It's under a year old. You guys approved the tree trimming approach.
Okay.
Any other questions?
We just ran out of money.
Any other questions? Yes.
Mr. Bach, do we have any complaints coming up in a Fairlane sub with low riding trees?
We get complaints in several areas of sub. We're trying to get to all of them. We're making pretty good progress.
Okay.
Yeah.
Any other questions on the site? All right. Item 18 is motion to approve Great Lakes Contracting Solutions LLC to perform concrete pavement repairs at various locations east of Monroe to Ziegler and north of 94 to Van Born for the estimated amount of $220,000. Funds provided from local road accounts. Mr. Bach.
This is in the same area, and just a side note, if I'm not correct, if I'm wrong, Jason, but we got to found this money in the existing budgets before the budget year and did an interfund transfer. So this is not anything we're taking from the fund balance. This is in the existing budget.
Okay. And this is part of the Good to Great program, right?
Yes.
Okay.
I have a question.
Yes, Councilwoman?
Is this for the roads and for sidewalks and any
this is just for the roads.
Just for the roads.
Yep. And I'll make a point, it's not for every single problem in the roads because we have a budget to work with, but these are the major problems that we went out and marked. And it's
like
getting most of it.
This
potholes, you know, the big potholes. Curbs coming off, catch bases that are caving in the area around there.
They did my neighbor who lives right in front of us down there. Whoever did a really nice job. I'll let you know.
I have a question about the streets that were slated to get redone last year. I know Superior was one of them and Continental, and they, you know, we lost that time at the end of the season, and they got pushed to this year. So I'm just wondering, I know Superior has been worked on, but what about Continental or any of the other ones that were pushed back from last year?
They're supposed to get completed before we start any other streets. I'll check on Continental. I know Superior.
I think Superior may
yeah.
be done or almost
I can give
done.
You an answer tomorrow with Continental.
Okay, thanks. Continental north of Goddard and south of Wood.
Is there any other discussion on this item? Okay. Item 19 is motion to approve payment to North River Truck and Trailer Inc. for emergency repairs on the sewer vector and the amount of $5,993. Funds provided from the sewer account. Mr. Bach.
This is for a new hydraulic pump in our vector. It went out when we were using it, and both of our vectors are down. One's going to cost a little bit more, the other, and we're getting both of them fixed, but for now, this one is getting fixed on emergency. We should have it back tomorrow. This leads to the next one. We actually have to contract out a vector for some flooding issues because we didn't have one available because they were both broken.
Okay. Is there any questions for Mr. Bach on this item? Okay. Item 20, motion to approve invoice from United Resources for the amount of $2,046 for emergency cleaning to relieve flooding on Syracuse. Funds provided from local roads. Mr. Bach.
Vectors are broke down.
Any questions, Mr. Bach, on this item? All right. Item 21 is a motion to approve purchase of water coolers and waste enclosures for the Lakes of Taylor from JF Manufacturing, low bid, in the amount of $8,475.50, amount to be paid from Lakes of Taylor capital account. Mr. Dobek.
Yes, sir, Mr. Chair. These are enclosures that are in desperate need. Our old ones are dilapidated, beat up, rusted, so we need to replace them and we budget accordingly to do so.
Is there any questions from council?
Just like this here.
That's
you
the chair.
Any chairs on the table?
No, it was included in there with the freight cost. I think
yeah.
My gloves.
Yeah.
So just so we could show you that the freight cost is included.
Any other questions for Mr. Dobek? Item 22 is a motion to approve purchase of both flood damaged and replacement awnings at both Lakes of Taylor and Taylor Meadows from Bell Island Awning, low bid, in the amount of $34,938, $17,802 to be paid from insurance proceeds, and $17,136 to be paid from Lakes of Taylor's and Taylor Meadows capital accounts. Mr. Dobler.
Yes, Mr. Chairman. This is the awnings on the veranda at both Lakes of Taylor and Taylor Meadows. The ones at the Lakes of Taylor were taken down and stored in the cart barn. With the flood, they were full of water. They weren't dried out. They froze, and then they were full of mold and ripped when they were opened up. So that's going to be covered under the flood damage. The one at Meadows is over 15 years old. It's full of mold and mildew, and it's ripping. So it's time to fix that as well for all of our events under the veranda at both Lakes and Meadows.
Sure. Is there any questions for Mr. Dobek on this item? Item 23 is a motion to approve the purchase and replacement of beer coolers at the Taylor Meadows and the restaurants from the restaurant store Ravelry. Low bid in the amount of $4,742. Amount to be paid from Taylor Meadows operating account. Mr. Dobek.
Yes, Mr. Chairman. So these coolers are the beer and keg coolers at Taylor Meadows. We found that a lot of our units that we're dealing with are built in under the cabinets. We're ripping those out and buying portables for a few reasons. First, the cost. Second, for maintenance. And third, we get them in and out and as long as they fit. So this is a very economical way to have better units, newer units, that seem to work better for our applications at Taylor Golf.
So I noticed that on the backup it says beer coolers, and on the agenda it says bar coolers. So what are you storing?
So basically, the Meadows bar, when you sit up there behind the Meadows bar, that whole attached built-in unit is shot. Mm-hmm. So it holds two kegs, and then the last section is for bottled beer.
Oh, what is a beer cooler?
So it's kind of built for those three.
Okay.
Then we'll eliminate the long lines that run back into the kitchen and leak and have problems as well. So it seemed to work really well. Last year we did it at Lakes, and everybody's happy with the temperature of the beer.
Cold communication part.
Any other questions in the sense? Item 24 is a motion to approve the home deferred loan for homeowner as stated in the amount of plus 10% contingency, $8,601 through Aches and Sons Insulation, low quote, funded through the Community Development Block Grant Housing Rehabilitation Program, not to exceed program limits. Mr. Bond.
Thanks, Chairman. This is just a home deferred loan for a homeowner that failed in need of insulation. Second time we put out the bid, the first bid came back almost $20,000, we put back out the bid. This vendor, background check, worked out. Good to go.
Okay. Any questions for Mr. Bauman's site? All right. Next is item 25. It's a motion to approve payment in the amount of $11,700 to National Faith Home Buyers for the down payment assistance of 2018-07 and 2018-08, funded through the home grant. Mr. Bauman?
Chairman, this is a down payment assistance for two qualified applicants. We're getting a couple more applications in a day, so we're booming with those, but both applicants met all guidelines.
Are there any questions for Mr. Bond on this item?
I have a question on this item. Like, can I go back to 24? Is this the first time you've worked with Ace and Sons, though?
It is. Yes. But we did merit check, sand okay. check, and they checked out.
Is there any other questions for item 25? All right. 26 is a motion to approve payment for Monster Premium Job Ads in the amount of $2,850 to be paid out of the general fund. Ms. Corsi Schultz.
Thank you, Chairman. This is a bulk purchase of ads through Monster. We save significant amount by purchasing. We're getting each ad for about $237, where normally we'd be over $300. The particular ad that we buy to markets not only to Monster, but 500 sites, other job recruiting sites, hits all the social medias, Instagram, the Twitters, the Facebooks, And it also does sites that are available for veterans who are looking for work, as well as multiple diversity websites that are advertising opportunities.
Okay, is there any questions for Ms. Gorsuch-Schultz on the site? Item 27 is a motion to receive and file the Taylor General Employees Retirement System Investment Performance Review, period ending March 31st, 2018. Ms. Gorsuch-Schultz.
Thank you, Chairman. This is the quarterly investment report that we received and filed with council. This is obviously through the first quarter. A tough quarter, pretty much across the board. We still were in the top 10 performance-wise in terms of other municipal pension fund systems. So it was just, you know, from the investment market, it was just a tough quarter for everyone.
Any questions for Ms. Gorsuch-Schultz on the site?